In this part, we're going to talk about the transformations required to go from a lumped element circuit to a transmission line based circuit. So we know what we're trying to do here. We're dealing with a bandpass filter, which can be precisely represented using lumped elements. We can arrive at the lumped element circuit, such as that shown here, directly from a Chebyshev description in this case. And we want to go from here to a transmission line realization, the parallel coupled line realization. Now, of course, what we're talking about here is a filter design process, a synthesis process, but this concept can be used for any time we want to realize a circuit function using transmission line. We start seeing our microwave structures as just another circuit. Of course, people who only deal with low frequency circuits wouldn't see it that way. But an experienced RF designer, experienced microwave designer, sees structures that simply don't look like lumped element R, L, and C components. They see it as a circuit. So we're going to begin with a lumped element filter. The circuit shown there is a third order filter. We know it's going to be Chebyshev because we've used the Chebyshev polynomials to help us decide on the element values. But there is a dual as well, shown on the right there. We could begin with either of those. Now we're going to look to see whether we can implement this with coupled lines, because we know coupled lines intrinsically have the type of response that we want. We want to fine-tune that a little bit, we want to control the bandwidth, we want to control the order of the filter, but we know that coupled lines with appropriate matching will have the type of characteristic that we want. So we're in the process working out the steps to go from the lumped element circuit to a transmission line based circuit. And people didn't dream of this overnight. It took many people over many years to come up with these ideas, because of course they didn't know it could be done to begin with. But now we know that it can be done. Here is our lumped element third order filter. And just perhaps the transmission line equivalent has three resonators. Our lumped element circuit has three resonators. Here's a central parallel LC resonator. Here is a series LC resonator. And here's our third resonator, also a series LC circuit. So perhaps, this is the thinking that the people would have had in the early days, perhaps this can be realized using three transmission lines, each of the transmission lines being lambda on 4 long at the center frequency of the filter, so that each of those transmission lines looks like a resonator. Now, the way we analyze this circuit is that we would consider this as two pairs of coupled lines. So let's look at the coupled line circuit. The circuit shown on the bottom here, that's this one down here with the transformers, is our circuit model for a pair of coupled lines. The way we show the equivalence is that we equate the ABCD parameters of the two circuits. Our coupled line structure here is seen as a layout. So these are our two microstrip lines over a ground plane. And so the full description of that coupled line structure is going to include even and odd mode characteristic impedances. In the equivalent circuit here, we have two transmission lines, and these are simply two conductor transmission lines. So they're described simply by their characteristic impedances, Z01 and Z02 here. Now, how did somebody come up with this structure and realize that this is the equivalent circuit for a pair of coupled lines? Well, it would have taken a lot of iteration. It fits into the category of a real invention, but this is the equivalent circuit. And if you equate the ABCD parameters, you see that this is the equivalence between the coupled line structure at the top and the equivalent circuit. We can get the value of the transformer coupling, the system characteristic impedance, and then the characteristic impedances of each of those individual transmission lines. Now let's continue on and look at our comb line structure. So here is our comb line section on the left. Here is the equivalent circuit for our coupled lines. And here's the equivalent circuit again. And now we see in the comb line circuit, we have two ports, ports 4 and 3, that are short circuited. So we're going to short circuit those. And now we can collapse that circuit into a simpler form. So here is the shorted coupled line equivalent circuit again. The first transformation we will use is to note that a short circuit across a transformer, an ideal transformer at that, is the same as having a short circuit across the left-hand side. So let's start simplifying things down. So what we see here is that we've got rid of one transformer, this transformer here, and now we have two transmission lines, the Z02 transmission line and the Z01 transmission line. If our comb line section is lambda on 4 long, then Z01 and Z02 will also be lambda on 4 long, and we can replace those transmission lines using our shorthand for stubs, as shown on the left there. Now we need to quantify things here a little bit. By saying that FR is equal to F0, we're saying that the resonant frequency of the stubs, that is the frequency at which they're lambda on 4 long, is the same as the center frequency of our equivalent circuit. Now we can go one step further. There is an equivalence for this transformer with a stub. Using that equivalence, we come up with a pi arrangement of stubs. Here, three shorted stubs, two in shunt, one in series, and they are resonant at the center frequency of our equivalent circuit. So now we know that if we can develop a synthesis process that will arrive at the structure shown there on the right, that is a pi arrangement of shorted stubs, then we're going to be able to replace it by a pair of coupled lines. We have taken our process where we're trying to go from a lumped element circuit to coupled lines, and we've reduced that to a process that tries to start off with a lumped element equivalent circuit for a bandpass filter, and now we want to translate that and come up with a pi arrangement of stubs, because once we have that pi arrangement, we can turn it into coupled lines. We can create that physical realization. So let's see where we are at the moment. We want to come up with this pi arrangement of shorted stubs. And here is our lumped element bandpass filter, and there are three resonators. So far, so good. The pi arrangement of stubs is an arrangement of three resonators. Our bandpass filter has three resonators. And each stub is a resonator, but here is the problem. A shorted stub corresponds to a parallel LC resonator, and an open circuited stub corresponds to a series LC resonator. So a direct implementation of this lumped element circuit using stubs will not arrive at three shorted stubs. So the conversion from a lumped element filter to a pi network of shorted stubs is not direct. But the idea is starting to come through. So in summary, the key idea is to begin with a lumped element filter prototype and put the circuit in the form of a collection of shorted stubs in a pi configuration. And this is the model of two parallel coupled lines in a comb line configuration. But we cannot start from this lumped element circuit, because each of the series LC resonators is modeled by an open circuited shunt stub. We're right with the parallel LC circuit that comes out as a shorted stub, and our third resonator is modeled just as our first resonator was, with an open circuited stub.